ni Sir ni President Marcos ang anything about the welfare of the teachers during ISONA. So I would just like to ask if ano po ang plans ni VP Sara about sa welfare ng teachers. Will she support the salary upgrade and provision of health benefits po? Thank you.
Thank you. Medyo mahaba yung sagot dyan, no? Okay. So with the welfare of the
President Marcos on anything about the welfare of the teachers during ISONA. So I would just like to ask if ano po ang plans ni VP Sara about sa welfare ng teachers. Will she support the salary upgrade and provision of health benefits po? Thank you.
Thank you. Medyo mahaba yung sagot dyan, no? Okay. So with the welfare of the teachers, definitely dun sa pagre-review natin unang-una ng curriculum, we're also trying to really upgrade our teaching standards, no? So what will happen is that meron pong plano ang ating department headed by the Vice President and Secretary Sara Duterte na ease off yung mga administrative tasks ng mga teachers, kasi napapansin na bukod sa pagtuturo, meron din silang admin tasks. So sa ngayon, ang plano natin, we need to upskill yung ating mga teachers. So dahil doon, ang gagawin natin is mag-focus muna sila sa teaching, tatanggalin natin yung mga admin tasks. To complement that, we will perhaps have to hire non-teaching staff to handle those things, no, at least for the teachers. Now, pagdating naman po doon sa question ng salary, the market standard kasi po ng salaries sa Philippines in general would be, especially when you're talking about government employees, would be the private sector. No, sa ngayon, dahil sa salary standardization law, with the increases imposed since 2019, and I think the last tranche will be 2023, pataas na po ng pataas ang salaries ng ating teachers. No, to the point na there is data that their salaries are actually already better than their counterparts in the private sector. So at the moment, ang immediate natin gagawin talaga, because we have to balance those things. Kasi if we increase the salaries of the teacher, basic wage, I'm talking about basic wage, if we make it too high, it will really affect the private sector, kasi either lilipat yung mga teachers from the private sector to the government, no? Or baka hindi kayanin ng private sector tapatan, baka magsira yung private sector. But in saying that, narinig naman po ni Vice President Secretary yung hinaing ng mga teachers. That's why po what we will be doing is that we will be looking into non-basic wage benefits, no, that we can give them para naman po madagdagan yung take-home nila. And in fact, this has already been presented to the President, and he has instructed for that to be looked into, na yung mga non-basic wage benefits, tingnan natin kung ano yung pwede pa nating madagdag para sa aumento ng mga take-home pay ng mga teachers po. Thank you.
Sir, follow-up na lang po dun sa non-basic benefits. Ano po yung kasama dun?
Right now po kasi there are several allowances basically that we are looking into, no? Either overload ng teaching load, you know, all those things. I don't want to preempt whatever yung pag-aaral na gagawin doon sa non-basic wage benefits, no? But at least for the immediate, that is the thrust, no? Yun muna yung titingnan natin para matugunan din natin yung mga...
Maraming salamat. At kung ikaw ay interesado ng mga bidyong tulad nito, mangyaring suportahan ang channel na ito sa pamamagitan ng pagpindot ng like, pag-share ng mga video, at kung bago ka pa lang sa channel na ito, please subscribe sa channel na ito at pindutin ang notification bell at piliin ang all upang maabisuhan ka para sa mga paparating pang mga videos.